My viewers, we have now closed the application for candidates who could contest for AUC seat. And this is my observation. And if you remember very well, I was the first person to endorse Raila. But you see, Raila has a unique followers whom you can praise him 999 times, nobody notices. And even and if you ask them, you see, 999 times have praised your person. They'll say, but you have not praised him. When was anybody? When did anybody else sit down and be asked why he's praising Jesus? You see, you're just doing your duty. But the one time you'll be deemed, let me say deemed, to say something against him, they'll forget the 999 times you have done that, and they will go against you. They'll use all abusive words. Yeah, they will even take their reasonability aside. But who am I? Mine, hii ni jitenge bwana, tutajitenga. I'll have to say one thing. Mine is to say about what comes out of my head and my heart. Obviously, it could be right, it could be wrong, because I am not in Raila's secretariat, neither am I anybody's place to come into confidential reports. But from where I'm seated, I can tell you that this thing is for Raila's for the taking, except there are some underlining things that you may not notice. To tell you the truth, you know, politicians are people who they are no different from Kina Kanyari, because a politician will praise you like Moi used to praise. There's a time Moi praised Saitoti, but he had just signed a list where Saitoti was not on the list. So politicians would laugh with you. That night, it is said that it was at 3 a.m., there was a night meeting in State House, Mombasa, where three people met: Olusegun Obasanjo, Raila, and Ruto. The watchman that day, I think the watchman that day was his day off. Rigiji was on off duty, because his duty was to make sure that Raila does not enter State House. But they waited until the day when Rigiji was on off. That is when Raila entered Uko, Mombasa. And he entered with Olusegun Obasanjo. It was agreed. But you see, that date to today, when nominations are being closed, was a long time. And in politics, a week is too long. So Raila was told to go slow on Maandamano, on the basis that he'll be supported. Now, fast forward to Gen Z. Gen Z started going around. And you see, Raila is that type of a person who, when he's driving by, he sees a crowd of people Maandamano, he'll tell the driver, simamisha niingie kwa hiyo Maandamano. So when Gen Z's were demonstrating, Raila was feeling bad because he should have been there. But you see, the girl gave Raila a very good exit plan when she told Raila, you have done your part, leave everything to us. But you see, you can take a village out of the village, but you can't take the village out of the village, isn't it? You can take Raila out of demonstration, but you cannot take demonstration out of Raila. And yet again, Raila was also planning to show plan B. You see, as I told you, politicians is the last person you can trust. So Raila, even right now, only a fool would trust her. You know, it can even happen on the last day. Raila, you see, 53 countries will vote. They have vote. But Ruto has a veto. If you know what a veto is and what a vote is, the spelling is the same, but the rearrangement makes veto mean different from vote. So Raila wanted to show his muscle. He wanted to show his muscle over demonstration when he started siding with Gen Z. But then suddenly Madam Suluhu sacked her foreign affairs minister. And you know, hii kazi ya AUC, there is a written, unwritten, kizungu ni ngumu, there is an unwritten law that says prime ministers and or foreign affairs. If you have been a prime minister and you have been a foreign affairs twice combined, then you stand a very good time, chance. And this thing was very good for Jakaya Kikwete. But Jakaya Kikwete didn't want. Maybe he's timing the United Nations, maybe. So he didn't want. And then Raila kanza kulega lega hivi. Then Suluhu relieved of January Mwakamba. Yeah, he relieved January Mwakamba of his foreign ministry. And you know, January Mwakamba is more popular outside Tanzania than inside Tanzania. You see, a politician's fight, seven fights in the same time. Yes, Ruto may have called Suluhu and said, Saidia. Suluhu also knows that Mwakamba may be a candidate for the presidency in the near future. So she would release Mwakamba, showing him that he should be loyal until the last minute. At the same time, as unajua vitu zinaenda mingi. Sasa Mwakamba kuacha kazi. And you see, if a Tanzanian would have contested, I'm telling you, ingenini. But then, currently, there are only two candidates remaining. The one candidate is Raila, who stands at 90% chances. And then there is the Djibouti Foreign Affairs Minister, who stands at 9%. Don't ask me about that 1%. That 1% belongs to Huatenge, son of Lando. Now, you see, Raila has 90% chances. The Djibouti Foreign Affairs has 9%. But was it yesterday or the day before yesterday? There are other two nobodies who have come. One is from Mauritius and another from... First of all, Mauritania and Mauritius, yeah. Mauritania and Mauritius are confusing country because nobody knows whether they're in East Africa or South Africa. Eh? That is the problem we have. Mutu wa kabila mbili. Sasa kama mimi nikisimama, some people may say, hey, kabila ya mama yake, unajua akichaguliwa tena kabila ya mama yake imewahi kuwa, or kabila ya babake sijui nini. So we people who belong to two tribes, is an advantage, is also a disadvantage. Also, Mauritius and Mauritania are two tribes because they can claim to be South Africans and they can claim to be East Africans. So, siasa inaweza tokezea kwanza, those people are nobodies. Ukienda kwa capital yao, they even don't know them. Hmm? Nobody knows them in their capitals. So, how ni watu wa kusindikiza tu. Or wale wananyemelea, like Uhuru Kenyatta said, anafuata mkono, fisi anafuata mkono ianguke ndio. Ya kule. So those are the fishes who are waiting for mkono kuanguka. The real fight is between the Djiboutian and Raila. Now, the Djiboutian has 9%. And you know, he came to Kenya. Hmm? He came to see Musalia Mudavadi. You know, Musalia Mudavadi, although he's a acting cabinet minister for everything, including my ministry of propaganda, but... His substantive ministry is foreign affairs. His substantive ministry is foreign affairs. So he came to visit. How can you... Hey, it's like today you are campaigning for the president na unaenda kukampenia Kisumu. Now you know Raila is on the cabinet paper. Ballot paper. Eh? So he's coming to Raila's head. Nini? It could be a message that Ruto is sending to Raila. You know Raila, bwana? Chunga, you see. Between now and the... You know, Raila can play it. Hakuna mwanasiasa anaamini mwingine. Unaangalia hivi lakini unageuko na chunga huyu mwingine. Royal Rambo atakurusha juu ya kamba na abaki. So, on one side, Raila may pretend not to be and support jinsi. And also, at the same time, Ruto can be sending message. Wey, toe in line, vitu kama hizo. And that also explains things to do with the... cabinet. The four people were sent. Nini. So that is how it is. But take it to the bank. Not the river bank. Not equity. Just take it to the World Bank. That this thing is Raila's. We are just waiting for him. The only thing that can stop Raila are three things. If Raila reaches tomorrow and says, I'm not interested, he can't go. That is option number one. Option number two and number three, those are God's act, where maybe he's physically enabled or Jaramogi amemuita. But if he's going to maintain his health and if he's going to maintain his tempo the way it is, watu wa Kisumu, tengenezeni kuku. I'm telling you, the day will be soon, nitaenda kwa nyumba ya mtu na lazima unitolee kamongo nikule. This one was recorded as a reaction. I had promised you that after the closure of the application time, I'll talk to you. So this is the closure. And this is Raila's seat to lose. Thank you.